Have you ever taken a photo with a camera? We press the button and the picture of whatever scene is in front of the camera comes on the film, which are later converted into photographs. If I say that all of us have a natural camera, would you believe it? Yes, this is true. And those natural cameras are our eyes. All of you must have experienced this after looking carefully at anything. If you close your eyes, then the picture of it remains visible to us for a few moments. But how is this even possible? Have you ever thought of it? The whole game is about our eyes and brain. And today in this video, we'll know how the eyes help us to see any object in the world, and we'll also discuss the different parts of the eye. The human eye is roughly round in shape. The first part of the eye is called cornea. Cornea is a white and transparent membrane on the surface of the eye, whose function is to protect the eye from any foreign particle. Being transparent, only light can enter into the eye. Have you ever thought that why does any foreign particle cannot enter in our eye? Because the cornea stops it on the surface. After the cornea, the second part is known as iris. You must have seen that someone's eyes are black or someone's green or someone's blue. They are actually the color of the iris. In addition, the iris also controls the size of the pupil. The pupil is the part of the eye that controls how much light should enter into our eyes. When we enter a dark room or a room with a low light, for some time we do not see anything. Then slowly everything starts to appear. Ability to see in low light areas is possible only due to pupil. It actually expands and allows more light to enter into the eyes. The light passes through the lens after it enters through the pupil and creates an image on a surface located at the back side of the eye. Our eyes have convex lens, which is thicker at the middle and thinner at the edges. These lens are attached to the eyes by the ciliary muscles. These muscles control the size of the lens, due to which we are able to see the distant and nearby objects clearly. This surface of the eye is called retina. The retina works like a film in the eyes on which images of the objects are formed. Retina has two special type of cells, cones and rods, which becomes alive when the light falls on it. Cones get activated by the light, due to which we are able to see different colors. And rods get active in low light, due to which we see all objects in black or white. Being a convex lens, always a real and inverted image is formed on the retina. Then how do we see erect images of the objects? From here, the work of the brain begins, which is connected to the eye through the optic nerve. The brain converts the signal from the optic nerves and we see erect images. Apart from these organs, there are two types of humor filling in our eyes. First one is aqueous humor, which is a fluid filling whose function is to give nutrition such as glucose and amino acids to cornea and lens. The second tissue filling is the vitreous humor, which helps in maintaining the round shape of the eyes. So in today's video, we get to know about the different parts of the eyes and their functions. The eyes are as sensitive in the outside as well as in the inside. And there are people in the world who do not have eyes and cannot see anything in the world. So we should consider ourselves very lucky and be thankful that we are able to see this world with our own eyes. Spectacles or eyeglasses. You must have seen some people in your life wearing glasses. Some of your own friends too will be there who wear glasses. Why do these people wear glasses? We must have heard oftenly that their eyes have become weak, the vision is not clear, so they wear glasses. But what is the exact reason behind the eyes to be weak or the vision to get blurry? In our previous video, we learned about the various organs of the eyes. But weakening of which organ reduces the vision of our eyes? Stay tuned till the end of the video to find answers to some of the similar questions. But before knowing the defects of vision, it is important to understand a concept first, known as power of accommodation. What does the power of accommodation mean? Have you ever noticed that within a couple of moments we can see the distant objects and read the story written in the book without time lapse between the two episodes? But is it as easy as it looks? No. As we have already known that the lens in our eye changes its size or focal length with the help of ciliary muscles, due to which we are able to see these different objects in a time of a second. In order to see a nearby object, the ciliary muscles contract, then the lens becomes thicker and the focal length reduces, and we are able to see the nearby objects comfortably. In the second case, the ciliary muscles get relaxed, which makes the lens thinner and the focal length increases, which helps us to see the distant objects clearly. You must have noticed that you can't read while keeping a book very close to your eyes. Why is it so? Because our lenses can increase or decrease their focal length to an extent. For a normal eye, this distance is 25 cm, which is called near point. To read a book properly, we need to put it at least 25 cm away. Similarly, the far point is at infinity. One reason for the eyes to become weak is that the power of accommodation gets reduced. There are broadly four types of defects of vision. The first one is myopia, which is also known as nearsightedness. The person having myopia is able to see the nearby objects but finds it difficult to see the distant objects clearly. In this, the image of the object forms not on the retina but in the front of it. Now you may be wondering why the image is formed in the front of the retina instead of on the retina. They are formed because in this defect, curvature of the lens or the curvature or axial length of the eyeball increase, due to which the converging capacity of the eye increases and the image forms in front of the retina. This defect is common with the growing children because with time, the size of the eyes increases. These are the same children whose mention was there in the beginning of the video. If you ask them, they will say that we do not see the distant objects clearly. As the converging power increases in this defect, hence the converging power will have to be reduced to correct it. But the power cannot be reduced, so it is intended to diverge the light coming from the outside. And for this, we can put a divergent lens or concave lens in front of the eyes and let the image be formed on the retina. Second defect, which is also known as farsightedness or hypermetropia. A person with hypermetropia can see distant objects clearly but finds it difficult to see the nearby objects distinctly. In this case, the image is formed behind the retina. As the focal length of the lens increases or the eyeball shrinks, the image is formed behind the retina. So a converging or a convex lens is taken to converge it to the exact point, making the image on the retina. The power of the lens in both the cases is taken care by putting the lenses of the exact power in the spectacles. Apart from spectacles, these defects can also be overcome through various types of surgery. The third defect, which is known as presbyopia. In this defect, it is difficult for a person to see both far and near. Aging is the reason behind this defect for most of the people, where both the muscles and the lens get weakened. To correct this defect, doctors ask to wear eyeglasses of proper power having bifocal lenses. The lower part of these lenses is made up of convex lens and the upper part is made up of concave lens. Besides these three, there is another eye defect which people face during old age, known as cataract. But what exactly is cataract? We all have protein in the lens of our eyes. With increasing age, these proteins accumulate in the lens, and after a certain time, the lens becomes milky in color. Due to this, the lens loses its transparency and there is difficulty in seeing. The only way to cure this defect is surgery. The doctor replaces the defected lens with another artificial lens. Cataract is a very common disease from which we should not be afraid. The surgery lasts for just 15 to 20 minutes and the person's eyes become like the new one. But if cataract is not treated at the right time, then it can cause permanent blindness to the eyes. So kids, by this video we're able to understand what actually happens with those who wear eyeglasses and how much they go through every day which we can't even imagine. We got to know about the parts of the eyes, the defects of vision and their corrections in our previous videos. We also discussed how sensitive and complicated our eyes are. We have also learned how we can see distant and nearby objects. But the question is, can we see the various changes happening in the world? Or is there something that is not visible from our eyes? Some similar questions also arise in my mind when I see the rainbow. What happens suddenly after the rain that we see the rainbow? Or while looking at the open sky, the question arises in my mind, why it is blue? Why not green or red? So, do you want to know the answers to many such questions? Then stick with the video till the end. To find the answer to the first question, let's do this activity. To do this activity, we need a source of white light and a prism. Prism is an object made up of glass with two triangles and three imposing sides. The angle between any two rectangular surfaces is called the angle of prism. In a dark room, place the prism on the base of the triangle and focus light on any of the rectangular surfaces. As soon as the light falls on the prism, on the other side we'll see a band of some colors. If you look at the band carefully, it has seven colors in it: violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, and red. These seven colors can be remembered as vibgyor. This strip of colors is called the spectrum of light, and the splitting of the seven colors of light is called dispersion. The prism refracts light and changes its direction. If you look carefully, then you'll find that each color makes a different angle with the prism and travels on its own path. Isaac Newton was the first person to obtain the spectrum of sunlight. He then uses the second inverted prism to obtain the single beam of white light. Newton said that the white light is made up of seven colors. So, is the reason for the formation of rainbow is also the dispersion of white light coming from the sun? Yes, but we do not see any prism. Then how does the process take place? After the rain, small drops of water are present in the atmosphere. Through these drops, the light gets refracted, get dispersed into seven colors, and then reflects internally and falls on our eyes. Which is why we see the rainbow. It is to be kept in mind that the rainbow always forms in the opposite direction of the sun. So does the sun only produce white light, or is there anything else that we cannot see? Yes, electromagnetic waves produced by the sun ranging from radio rays to gamma rays. Every beam has its own wavelength. Some of them get stopped in the atmosphere and some reach to the earth. We can only see the spectrum of white light by our naked eyes. We'll read about these waves in detail in higher classes. These rays fall on various objects in the world. Every object has its own capacity of absorbing light. So, why do we see apples in red color? Because the apple absorbs all the colors except the red one, which gets reflected, and we see the apple as red in color. So, what is there in the sky that it seems blue? Does the sky as well absorb all the colors like an apple and reflect the sky blue color back? The answer is no. When these seven colors enter atmosphere, then they pass through the molecules of air and diminished particles present in the atmosphere, which are too small as the wavelength of the light. These particles scatter the blue light and make the sky appear blue in color. Now you must be thinking, if it depends on the wavelength, then why does the sky doesn't look violet, as it has the shortest wavelength? So now if sky appears blue due to the particles of the atmosphere, then why do we see the sky as red in the morning and evening? If you look at the time of morning and evening, then it can be seen that the sun is near the horizon and the light coming from the sun travels in the atmosphere for a longer time, while in the afternoon this distance decreases. Due to being in atmosphere for a longer time, blue and violet rays already get scattered and the red color reaches our eyes. These different colors are applications of Tyndall effect only. The scattering of light by colloidal particles in any medium gives rise to Tyndall effect. Sunlight coming from the open corner in a dark room is an example of Tyndall effect. So today we have learned that behind every visible or invisible phenomenon, the secret of science is hidden. There is definitely a rationale behind every change happening in the world. Science says that we should question why any change is happening. We don't know that any one of you might help us understanding the world better by your invention or discovery like Newton did.